This is Chris from All Guns 101, and today we're going to show you how to clean a pistol. This is my Beretta 9mm semi-automatic, 92FS. Let's do a quick teardown and show you how to clean a pistol here. So, I already entered my code. First of all, we always verify a firearm is safe. Nothing in the magwell. Nothing down the chamber, so we are good. We know we're safe here. So with this firearm, it's very simple. We'll keep it decocked. All you have to do is on this side, you have a button. You depress. You pull your tab down. Slide back and slide forward. So now you have your firearm in two pieces. Very simple to clean it. This is probably one of the easiest pistols I've ever owned to clean. From here, you decompress your spring. As you see the motion, it slides in and out. We can move this aside. That's free. For this point on, push down. That's all it is. Very simple. Let's just put that back in. You either push down on your barrel. I usually just push the pin in here, which is your firing pin, which as you can tell, the gun itself is not very dirty. I don't know if you have a good angle. Let me just put that in place. Hopefully you can see what I see. It's not very dirty, but I like to keep my guns very clean. So from this point on, we'll just move over to my cleaning kit. Need 9mm patch. Need my 9mm and or 35 cal. Same thing with my patches. I have 38 to 10mm, which would include 9mm. In my set here, I'm gonna go to this is the OEM pistol cleaning rod they gave me with the gun. Piece of plastic, nothing special. We have a fiber plastic brush. Then we have the brass. What I use to clean all my firearms, I use CLP. Break Free, I find so far it's the best stuff out there. It's very hard to find now in Canada. I'm gonna guess because it's full of chemicals and it's gonna kill me slowly. So we make sure to do this in a well-ventilated office. Or a 10x10 room, as I like to call it. So what I do is I give it a little shot down the barrel. As you see, it foams up real good. Take the brass. Firm grip. This is just an old t-shirt I have no need for. It's good for that. Just give it a few passes. If we can see, put that back in. You can tell now it's a little bit dirtier. I'm getting all the unburnt black powder out. Usually I like to do this several attempts, several shots, as you can tell. Get rid of all the copper, and right there, you see right there? That's what's in your firearm. The last time I shot this, it's been a few months. So I'm probably looking at maybe about 200 to 300 rounds that went through it the last time. So with that, I know that I've got quite a bit, but it's not the end of the world. It's still gonna fire, it's gonna operate fine. But just to prevent any jam ups, any dirt, any shit from getting inside, make sure we clean it nice and well. You're gonna see that I'm gonna use the plastic brush just because I don't have any brass brushes. I'm gonna clean off all the parts that I can, anything that will have black powder on it. These are all the parts that you need to move, as you can tell, so you don't want any of this to gum up because that's what's gonna prevent you from being able to fire a gun in the future. Same thing with the plastic brush, I'm gonna pass it through several times. The slide itself, there's really not much moving parts, but I'll still give it just around the firing area. Just a quick little scrub. Get rid of everything loose. These parts, this is where you get most of your contamination, if you ask me, besides the barrel itself. But if we just do a quick wipe down, you see, not an enormous amount, not a copious amount of unburnt. But still, it's shit you don't want on your gun in the long run. If you want a proper operating gun, it's always best to have it cleaned. I used to clean my gun every time I went shooting. Now I've calmed down a little bit. I'll clean it after every you know, month or so that I've gone. These are 100% cotton patches. bought the bag of 1,000 patches off of eBay from China somewhere. Don't really care about the quality of the patch. It's at the end of the day, you just want 100% cotton. The synthetic stuff, if you ask me, is real garbage. Doesn't work that well. It doesn't absorb anything. So I like to stick to what I know, which is cotton. And with the removal of the oil, you don't want to leave a heavy coat. You want to leave a very light coat of oil on the firearm just to prevent rust, just to make sure it stays nice and clean. It doesn't really matter at the end of the day, because once you go shoot the gun, you're going to burn it all off anyways. This part here is basically, you're just going to pass a patch through. It's going to get off all the crap, as you see right here. All the uncleaned gunpowder that sticks to the walls. I'll run, you know, 3-4 patches through, try to just get it as clean as I can. Like I said, it's a handgun. It's not really made for precision shooting. It's just for shits and giggles, if you ask me. I'm not a professional shooter at any point or any form. So what I'm doing here is I'm just going to put a clean patch in with just a little bit more CLP, and that's just going to really help get off all the crud on the inside. Patch is still good. We got most of it knocked out, so I'm just going to run it again. And then one last patch through the barrel to get off all the excess, which, as you can tell, it's almost a perfectly clean patch. There's still a little bit on there. I'm not going to fuss too much. We're just going to clean off the small parts here. And don't forget, whatever doesn't come off as an oil, we'll try this again. Like I said, I really don't know if you could see, but nice mirrored finish, nice and clean on the inside. Rifling still strong, no copper filing, no nothing. So it means that you've done an efficient job at cleaning it, and that it's not going to cause you an issue. If you're a horrible shot like I am, you can't blame your guns. So to put it back together, we drop this into place. As you can tell, very simple. Like I said, you can either push it out there, or I just pull it out through the tab here. So we'll drop that in place. From here we have our spring. The spring you could clean down every once in a while, give it a little dab of oil. I recommend it. You don't have to. It's just what I like to do. This is all plastic, by the way, so if you can get a steel pin, it's going to probably last a lot longer. To reassemble, once this is all together as in so, take your frame, line it up in the back. You're going to have two little notch teeth. Slide it back. Slide it all the way back. Flip the little pin. Now your gun is fully assembled. So we're going to make sure it doesn't come loose. Everything holds together. So with that, that is how you clean a Beretta 92 FS. Hope you enjoyed, and please subscribe.